I will talk about the configuration of this system. First, open the project. You can see that there are two folders. The first one is the main folder of this system. The other is the demo folder. It shows you how to use this system. You can use it directly by modifying the blueprints in the demo folder. I have made some blueprints of common functions. Here's a showcase map you can open and play it. The other way to set up, you can delete the demo files. Or you can migrate the main folder to your project. Then let's talk about character setting. Open the first person character template. Add a grenade component to your character. Adjust the location to the location where you want to launch a grenade. I'm using a parent socket or hand R. The default rotation angle is negative 30. You can modify it to adjust the throw direction offset. You can call the throw function or grenade component to launch the grenade. You can use setGrenade class to change grenade at runtime. You can also set the rotation angle dynamic. For the damage count, open the class setting and add a if grenade interface to the character which you want to count the damage from the grenade. You can just copy the event I create in this blueprint to your character blueprint or create your own. I also create a healthy bar and blueprint here. All the grenades are inherited from the Master Grenade. Here are some variables that can be modified, such as explosion range and explosion damage. The explosion module is spread from the grenade module. In the explosion module, there are also some variables that can be customized, such as explosion sound effect, explosion FX. After you know the system well enough and are comfortable with it, then you can customize and expand it. Due to the complexity of the system, you need to debug the content of your extension by yourself. I don't recommend making massive changes to existing code. You can just modify a few parameters. If you have any question, please leave a comment. I'll try my best to help you.